that he who invented consciousness would have a lot to be blamed for, but he also forgot that without consciousness he would have no access to true happiness. So much for the wonder. Not for the mystery. This is a mystery that has really been extremely hard to elucidate. All the way back into early philosophies, and certainly throughout the history of neuroscience, this has been one mystery that has always resisted elucidation, has caused major controversies, and there are actually many people that think that we should not touch it. We should just leave it alone. It's not to be solved. I don't believe that, and I think the situation is changing. It would be ridiculous to claim that we know how we make consciousness in our brains, but we certainly can begin to approach the question, and we can begin to see the shape of a solution. And one more wonder to celebrate is the fact that we have imaging technologies that now allow us to go inside the human brain and be able to do, for example, what you're seeing right now. These are images that come from Hannah DeMasi's lab, and it's showing in a living brain the construction of the brain. And this is a person who is alive. This is not a person that is being studied at autopsy. And even more, and this is something that one can be really amazed about, is what I'm going to show you next, which is going underneath the surface of the brain and actually looking in the living brain at real connections, real pathways. So all of those colored lines correspond to bunches of axons, the fibers that join cell bodies to synapses. And I'm sorry to disappoint you, they don't come in color, but at any rate, they are where the colors are the codes for the direction of whether it is back to front or vice versa. At any rate, what is consciousness? What is the conscious mind? And we could take a very simple view and say, well, it is that which we lose when we fall into deep sleep or when we go under anesthesia, and it is what we regain when we recover from sleep or from anesthesia. But what is exactly the stuff that we lose under anesthesia or when we are in dream sleep? Well, first of all, it is a mind, which is a flow of mental images. And of course, consider images that can be sensory patterns, visual, such as you're having right now in relation to the stage and me, or auditory images, as you're having now in relation to my words. That flow of mental images is mind. But there is something else that we're all experiencing in this world. We are not passive exhibitors of visual or auditory